Now, you guys probably, you know, there's probably a large amount of you that know this, but there might be some that, you know, in 1993, I started hunting the ridge systems of Pennsylvania, northern Pennsylvania. It was about a 600 to 700 foot change in elevation, and it was, I had to learn quickly how the wind and the thermals moved around those hills. Now, a lot of times I found that the wind moves like water. It moves like water down draws and over the top of ridges. And I think this is a similar situation. I'm hunting at the top of a ridge point, and I have free air over here. What I mean by free air is that I don't have any hills obstructing that air system. It's just free right to the sky over this way. And so once this stand location is above the ridge system and is above this crest right here, then I'm going to be able to capture that clean air that's coming in from the southwest direction. I'm going to get that pure southwest. If I move the stand about 10 feet below, then what I'm going to get is a curling effect. That wind's going to come over this crest, it's going to come below and curl right back up. And so I could be sitting in a position right here with my stand about 10 feet below and actually spook deer right up on top of this ridge line where I'm actually observing. So just a little bit of a stand strategy, but it's real important that if you want to capture this clean air that's up top and you want that true wind direction, you have to get your stand above the crest, and you'll be able to fool a deer's nose a lot easier when you don't have to worry about that curling effect. And when you think about it, it's a lot of times water holes, waterfalls, that's why there's a cave behind there, because the water's coming over the top. It eventually erodes back into the hillside. And it's the same with wind. It's going to curl right back up. It's going to go right back at those deer. So as long as I'm just about 10 feet high, a few feet higher than that ridge, I'm going to get that clean air and we'll be all set.